Ask.
Been an effort to ask.
The radio don't want to play nothing that got no reality in it.
Yeah, man, I guess so. Let me go take a piss real quick and we'll be out.
Shit. Fuck it.
I've been knowing Too Short about 10 years.
I met him, when he was selling tapes out of his car, him and Freddie B. You know, about 10 years ago.
He used to come, you know, to house parties and rap, house parties and stuff like that.
I've been with Ty since we began. Since we, you know, used to carry our own tapes all the way all over to San Rafael.
Short dog ain't changing, so forget it. You can sell out if you want to, homie. But I'ma stay short but funky.
Chicago, and Too Short has always been large in Chicago.
And I've been knowing him for several years around the neighborhood. Listen to all his music.
He has, I believe, the most hardcore following of any rap artist out today.
I've been a dog ever since I was young. I saw the Mac and got oh so sprung. I couldn't help it. I had to be just like that. With a stable of hoes and my pockets fat. But don't trip. I made up my mind when I was sick.
Players Ball is being held for me, but I'm just coming as a guest myself. I'm not really the host, you know. I guess I'm just another player. I don't know. We'll see how that goes when it goes down. I'm looking forward to being there, and you know, I put on my little sweet kick and it's cool.
Right past me, bitch. Now you're looking back. All dogs must chase the cat, so here I come.
Like, this brother is the shit. I mean, because he invented that underground bitch, suck my dick, and all this type of. There wasn't nobody kicking nothing like that. NWA, Ice Cube, Eazy-E, they wasn't kicking no shit like that way back in 82, 83. And everybody give it to them as the originators of that style. Short was doing that way back in the day. I mean, I was like 12, 13 years old hearing this man say some outlandish shit that I ain't even heard in my life.
One of the first bad articles that was written about me was saying that I should not rap dirty because I don't do it good and I'm just trying to copy off Two Live Crew and NWA and Eazy-E and stuff like that. And, you know, I'm reading it going, God, you know, I was rapping 7 years before I ever heard of NWA. You know what I'm saying? I was rapping 5 years before I even heard Two Live Crew sing about they wanted some pussy. So to me, that's the kind of stuff that doesn't make me feel spiteful or anything like that. I just let it go in one ear and out the other. And one day I'll get my credit. When they look back on the whole story, they'll say, damn, you know, Too Short, it's been around, and I have.
I mean, Short proved it wrong. Short got, what, two platinums? He proved that, I mean, you ain't got to go R&B to get a platinum album, you know what I mean, Short, Stage Street, platinum album. He got two platinum albums and a gold. And one of the other albums just went gold. You know what I'm saying? He Straight Street. You ain't got to sell out.
Where they at? Where they at? Where they at?
I sold tapes every day, me and Freddie B. Been famous since 1983. Give me $10 and you straight get blessed. A rap all about you called the Special Request.
Okay. He used to make tapes for a lot of people. And you could request a tape from him, and he would put your name in it, and you would get the tape in a couple of days or so, and the tape would be all about you.
He used to make tapes for us in high school. You know, in our cars and stuff, like individual tapes about that certain person.
You know, we've been in the streets selling tapes out the trunk of this car. He's come through Plymouth Rock, sent to all my friends, all our homies, you know.
Everybody always says Too Short sold 50,000 tapes out of the trunk of his car. Well, somewhere down the line, the story got twisted up a little bit. Where it originally started was when I was, let's say, 15, 16, 17, 18 years old, me and a friend of mine, Freddie B, we sold a lot of tapes on the streets. Now, I don't know where the story got mixed up, but I remember being on the bus and getting off the bus and walking with a bag of tapes. I wish I would have had a trunk to put them in. After a while, Freddie B had a car that we brought around in a little bit, but, you know, it didn't run for that long, you know? We were right back on the bus, so... You know, when I started my company in 87, we did do a lot of first-hand, you know, deliveries to the record store, not just the distributor. But most of our tapes were sold by a distributor, which we delivered. If you want to say I was selling them out of the trunk, you could, but I wasn't walking up on the corner with my car going, you want my tape out of the trunk? It never happened.
I met Short way back in high school. You know, I went to Free Junior High School. Short was over at Fremont High, and we should, you know, go against each other rapping and stuff.
People used to make jokes. They'd be like, man, you're too short for this and that. You know, it just was a too short thing. I don't know who thought of it one day, and it was a too short thing. And what I did was one day after I started rapping, this probably was 6 months later, you know, the joke wasn't even, you know, it wasn't even really that much of a joke anymore. And I just decided I'm going to call myself Too Short. It started off as Sir Too Short. Everybody used to be Sir this, Sir that. I was Sir Too Short.
8 years on the mic and I'm not joking. Sir Too Short coming straight from Oakland, California.
Short was out on tour and I had released my own album on my own label called Life of a Criminal. And I had a song on it called Fucking with Dank. And Short came back for something and he took the tape back, you know, took it with him on tour and let the partners hear it on tour. And everybody was like, when we get back, we're going to hook him up. So when they got back, exactly what they did, they just called me and hooked it up.
It originally started off as an independent label. When we first put together Freaky Tales and, you know, the whole Born and Mac album. And, you know, the part I told you about selling tapes out of the trunk, whatever you want.
It was when I was with Pooh Man back in the days. Bruce had our executive producer had died, and word on the street that me and Pooh was popping, and Short just picked us up through the streets, you know?
I would have to say, initially, I was influenced to rap by the Sugar Hill Gang. That was my first just, you know, and Sugar Hill Gang was like, the only real credit they get in the rap game is for being the first rappers to make a record. That's the only credit they get, and that's what I give them. They introduced rap to me. But I would have to say, lyrically and the style I've taken probably comes from, you know, listening to Grandmaster Flash, you know, really, really Melly Mel, I should say, because when he sang The Message, and he sang Survival, and he sang a lot of songs about real stuff in the streets, that kind of changed a lot of rappers to start taking on that style of speaking on real things. So I did it in my own way. I didn't necessarily bite his style or his ways or his lyrics or his even, you know, just his ideals. I kept it all for me as a writer. But I would have to say I was greatly influenced by the song The Message.
Thought it was dope. Everybody was like, it's too slow. I can't dance to that. I need something I could dance to. And I never could dance, so I didn't care about dancing no way. I was just into the funk. You know, that's all I wanted to hear. Something funky with a bass line, bass hitting it. It's always was in the systems and stuff, you know, so if it hit, it hit. Don't matter if it's fast, slow, pop, jazz, I don't care what it is. If it's hitting, it's hitting.
You know, I first started rapping, I told you, like, Sugar Hill Gang, it was like the Sugar Hill Gang, you know, the early Grandmaster Flash stuff, whatever came off Sugar Hill Records. And I guess the whole Too Short character image thing came about when I hooked up with Freddie B and we started doing the X-rated dirty raps, and we just stuck with it. It was never just a sex thing.
Lying on your dick, people like saying how they fucking all these broads every night on tour, ain't doing nothing, talking about this and my dick is super tight and I'm this, just fucking everything. Stop lying on your dick. You know, you ain't fucking. Stop lying. I can't fuck five times in the night. Shit. I mean, shit, I might have a hell of a neck, but I can't fuck no five bitches in the night.
I like to say Two Live Crew, they have their market. They sell a lot of records that, you know, it's all cool with me, but it's really a sex thing with them. With Too Short, it's not necessarily a sex thing. It's really a pimp thing. And, you know, with N.W.A., it's really a gangster thing. So there is a Too Short style in there somewhere. Two platinum albums. I do a lot of concerts all over the place. I seen the groupies. They do whatever you say, when you want it, how you want it, and where you want it. But I ain't tripping, because these are the 90s. So when a freak say to me she loves me, I just say something like this. I say, baby. Well, I grew up in the 70s. I grew up in the 70s, so my music has a 70s feel to it. It's not R&B. It's not, you know, 1960s soul or rock and roll. It's 1970s funk. That's what you hear when you hear Too Short. We imitate a lot of groups like Parliament Funkadelic, you know, Cameo, and One Way. Groups that just live by the funk, you know?
Won't you mind your own? I'm trying to sleep, so just leave me alone. Next time I see you, I do my duty, but tonight.
I'm having a good time tonight, you know? I'm having a good time.
Standing on a corner in a white Godfather hat. He drives a long black gangster Cadillac. He can steal a broad's mind, man, in 3 or 4 minutes. It's not how long you talk, bruh, it's what you put in it.
Look out! The shorty little pimp.
Yeah.
He walks with a limp.
Ooh, man.
Shorty the pimp.
Shorty the pimp is gonna be the real deal for 1992. Ladies and gentlemen, Too Short! Too Short! Too Short!
Yes, ma'am. It's my mother right here, y'all. Hey, no, I just want to say, it's a lot of people I see in here tonight. I've been seeing a lot of y'all for a lot of years, long time. A lot of people in here, long time. High school, all kind of stuff. But I guess the best part about it is I'm still seeing the same faces, you know? That's kind of cool, though. Ain't nothing changed. Ain't a damn thing changed. So, when this new album come out, y'all gonna see Short Dog. I ain't selling out. Damn show ain't MC Hammer and we in the house. I love it.
No gold ropes, no diamond rings.
But look at me now, 10 years later. Ask any MC if I rap greater. See, I'm known.
You know, it's been amazing. Your other two albums went platinum before the first album ever went gold. And I know Too Short to Pimp is going triple at platinum. I just got the message, bruh. Your first album just went gold. And I like Jive Records to bring it over here and present it to you. How about a nice round of applause for Brother Neil from Jive Records? Hey! Oh, I love it. I love it. That's the first one. Freaky Tales, y'all. It just went gold in 1992.
I want your name and your telephone number. You think I'm faking, but I'll call. We only got one night to do it all. I know, baby, it's such a pity. Tomorrow night, we hit another city. Cold Mackin' in the game, it's all we do. Me and the boys call a dangerous crew. I used to be local till I signed with Jive. Too Short then went nationwide.
Here's the winner.
I went to Georgia with the Too Short
jacket. Uncle Too Short, custom-made jacket. And it's going to have Shorty the Pimp on it. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please give a nice round of applause to Derek Smith, our overall winner. Hey, Derek, you go right up the front. They'll take care of you up the front.
It was rigged. I'm protesting.
How about a nice round of applause for all the people? Now, we don't have to leave here until midnight. I heard that, bro. I heard that.
From Chicago to Indiana, from Mississippi to Alabama, Louisiana, even Texas.
You get your good cops and you get your bad cops. The good ones, they usually, I would say a good cop is a cop that is really out to fight crime, you know? Not necessarily traffic violations. I think a cop that's just out to fight traffic violations, he is, you know, he's getting wrapped up in his job, a power superiority complex, you know, that type of thing. But a lot of cops out there, they aren't good. What they want to do is they want to harass you. They want to make sure that life is miserable for you. They want to make sure that you always have to pay a ticket. They get to know your car. They know your face. They know what cars you drive. They know where you live. They know where you do your dirty work. They know everything. So you get involved with those kind of cops, you get to know you. They know me. A lot of them, OPD, they know me. And I figure it's 1992. By now, I know you know I never sold any drugs.
He just be telling it really like it is in the town, far as our area. You know what I'm saying? People think it's California is weak, you know, sunny beaches and all that. But really, California ain't no different than New York, the Bronx, or anywhere else. You know what I'm saying? It's the same. You know, life is hard. You know, he just telling it like it is, you know?
You don't see nobody running around on the streets ringing nobody bells, but you do see young black teenagers getting killed. You do see them selling drugs. You do see them, people ODing. You do see people getting shot up. You don't see nobody running around dancing. Ain't nothing nice out here, man. Ain't nothing nice.
The stuff that he says in his music, he's nothing like it.
Don't believe that. He ain't. Don't believe the hype.
Bitch! Trademark.
I always want to know, when you wrote it, you must be something like Too Short. And I would say, whatever part of him that is me, you know, the bad parts that is, I don't really go around advertising. I'm such a nice person that it, they don't show anyway. So somewhere in there, I am a dog. You know, I used to want to be a pimp. But now, I'm just tired. I'm the businessman now.
Dirty and my dick got hard. That night, I fucked the bitch 3 times straight. Next night, we made another date.
I gave a concert and she came backstage. Fuck a bitch, I'm trying to get paid, but that pussy squeezed tighter than a vice grip. Fucked around and met this other bitch.
Word in the neighborhood is that my boy be getting really dogged, you know what I'm saying, just on the strength of the explicit lyrics. But explicit lyrics really be coming from the heart.
You gotta remember, I'm a training character when I do Too Short, so, you know, the character is a dog, so I gotta keep him alive and well, because he's cool.
Took my dick out the pussy, let me come in her mouth. She kept sucking like a veteran. I couldn't handle it, the limo door opened. It was Janet, she jumped in the car, they started kissing and shit. I kick back and let him have his dick.
Well, you know, everybody always crying about the First Amendment. Rappers are people like everybody else are. We have the right to say what we want to say, see how we want to feel. We're just talking about the streets and how we feel and the things that we see deep every day in our lives. So if we can't say it, man, who will say it? People like Too Short, people coming out of the hole, delivering the message of what's going on the streets.
Right, it's a freedom of speech type thing, you know what I'm saying? If somebody want to make some kind of point or opinion on the mic, that's what we should do, you know what I mean? It shouldn't be somebody's decision, but the person is selling the records, you know what I mean?
Tripping, bitch.
Every time I find myself in a relationship, my job causes a problem, believe me, because you say to yourself, you say, damn, he's singing this, you know, he's singing this shit, it's got to be something real about it, but the only real thing about it is that all my life I've been a writer. You know what I'm saying? I could always just, you know, I can lie good, you know? So I make up these good, wild stories, you know? And I really do go out in the streets and I kick it a lot. And the things you hear in the Too Short rap, maybe I didn't do it, but somebody did do it. It's real stuff. And I make it always sound a little better than it really happened. Make it funny, plus you gotta make it rhyme, so. You know, it's just me being a writer is what you get out of Too Short. And I've always been into, like, Donald Goins books, Iceberg Slim, all that kind of stuff. I read a lot about the black experience, so I've been into it since
so
I was a child.
So, in other words, you have a great respect for women. This is when Too Short performance performed with Todd Shore, in person, really respect, because I hear you really respect your mother.
Too Short is my character, 100%. I made him, I live it, you know what I'm saying? When I want to, I really do know how to separate the two. If I didn't, I'd be a pretty messed up brother in the head. I would, I think so. Into the music business, I was on an independent label called 75 Girls. There, I was fortunate enough to record 3 albums that were just mediocre. If those 3 albums would have been my introduction to America, I don't think, you know, those were like local albums. My homeboys, you know, everybody, I knew everybody in the Bay Area, you know, they loved Too Short. They had good songs on them, but I don't think that was really the kind of material I would have wanted to go nationwide signed under Jive Records, you know. So, by the time I got signed to Jive, I was in control of my own career. I owned the company. I was, you know, me and my manager and my other partner, and we pretty much controlled the destiny. And it's like, by that time, I had a lot of studio experience. By that time, I had a lot of writing experience. I even was able to pick and choose some of the stuff I sang years ago and pick some of the best lines and use them and write new stuff to go with them. So, you know, I've been doing this. Shorty the Pimp is my 7th album, and you know, it's like every time we go in the studio, we don't try to just come with the same formula. We try to, you keep the character the same, but the difference is you work harder on the music. And you don't try to, we're not trying to sell records for pop radio. We're trying to sell records to Too Short fans.
When Too Short comes out with the tape, everyone in Oakland is very much supporting him.
Yes,
all the way.
Definitely,
everyone.
For sure.
Everyone by
the whole community.
Is
East, West,
him.
North, whatever.
Definitely.
You know.
When we listen to a song we just made, we go, you think a Too Short fan would like that record? That's how we think. And I take it around to the neighborhoods and I let them hear it. So before you even hear the album, I let a lot of people hear a lot of songs that you'll never hear, that because so many people said, that song is so fucked up and weak,
that I wouldn't put that song on my album because so many people don't like it.
Oh, the word on the street is Too Short always be the man. He never abandons his fans. He does what they want. He gives people what they want. He's the man.
When I'm getting ready to release an album, the first thing I do, I would have to say, is take it straight to the homies in the ghetto. That's the first place I take it to, and I say, here, you can have it. You know, the Jive Records, they get mad at me now. I know they do. They get mad because I give away the tapes before they ever come out. But if I don't, so much will be missing. I need to hear from people I don't even know. They walk up and say, I heard your new album. The album's not even out. It's still, you know what I'm saying? It's 3 months before it's coming out, and they're like, I heard your new album. That shit is cool. And I'm like, okay.
You know, he ain't forgot about his homeboys. You know, especially the Plymouth Rock homies from Plymouth Rock, you know.
Okay, you got a car with a loud stereo, so I know if I give it to you, a lot of people are gonna hear it. And, you know, I give it to so-and-so over here because I know he's gonna go dub a few copies and sell it to some of his homeboys. So it's gonna get around, and I make sure always that I never let all the songs get out before we release it. Just like maybe about 3/4 of them. And there's always that little bit when you finally do get the album, you say, oh, I never heard that one, it's cool. So it makes for a slight buzz, and it's really a local thing, and I do it personally so I can get the feedback on which songs are fake. And every now and then, you get the song that 50% say I hate that song, and 50% say I like it. A song like that can make the album. It can, because you know, there's so many more that everybody likes. So it makes for a good little pre-production type thing.
Love in Oakland, bitch. Yeah. Niggas always talking about I love you. But ain't no love, bitch.
Man, it's a shame I can't be saved by John the Pope. I gotta be a pimp or selling dogs in this town. It's going on, and brothers doing that can't
win. You know, usually what we do when we put our albums together, we usually do like an album cover concept. You know, we think real deep about what do we want to call an album and what do we want it to look like while it's sitting on the shelf. It's more or less like a packaging type thing. So everything we sell, we want to look good.
I still can't read, I count money like a champ. Now ask me, why every day does the task force jack me? The story's been told 1,000,000 times about a boy growing up into a life of crime. I heard it before, you heard it too. But now, homeboy, it's just me and you. You see, people try to call us filthy trash, even though we live better and make more cash.
So, Shorty the Pimp, my friend Keenan Foster, who does keyboards and stuff for us, he came with this record called Shorty the Pimp, and he let me hear it. He said, I got something you should hear. And, you know, it was something I should hear, and I just liked it so much, I named the album Shorty the Pimp. And, you know, in any way, the album's already on the pimp tip, so Shorty the Pimp just fit everything real good.
Every time I dip into my stack, I'm buying cars, jewelry, and mobile phones, things I couldn't get with a high.
There's only 3 clean songs on the album. Stepdaddy, Hoochie, and I Wanna Be Free. The rest of them, there's a clean album out, it's called Shorty the Player. It'd be hard to find, you practically have to go to Kmart to find it. If you wanna find a clean album, go to Kmart, it's there. Actually, the only reason I do the clean albums is because I was told at an early stage in my nationwide career, you know, since I signed up in 88, I was told that there are a lot of large markets. A lot of large chain stores like Kmart, for instance, that will sell a lot of records. And they won't take explicit albums. They won't take 2 Live Crew as nasty as I Wanna Be, but they'll sell 2 Live Crew as clean as I Wanna Be, which was also an album. So, you know, every album I had since Life is Too Short has had a clean version. Life is Too Short had a clean version, Short Dogs in the House had a clean version, and Shorty the Pimp has a clean version. And usually what we end up doing is, of that clean version, we might sell 200,000, 300,000 copies through Kmart or through one of those chains that don't deal with dirty albums. So usually if we get 1,000,000 off the dirty album, we'll get 1,500,000 with a clean version of it. Well, the song called Hoes is basically, you know, that was, if you're gonna name the album Shorty the Pimp, you can't just talk about pimps, you gotta talk about hoes. So that's what it was originally called, Talking About Hoes. And I changed the name to just Hoes because it, you know, it sounded a little better. So it's just basically the song speaks for itself.
You get a pretty yellow bitch with that long ass hair.
fine motherfucker trying to get with a player. Can't fuck worth shit, old stiff ass bitch. Try to get some head and she just kissed my dick. I need a bitch with a beeper, a full time tramp. She can't suck dick like she's licking a stamp, but she can lick it all around or swallow it whole. Deep throw this dick and act real bold.
In the Trunk is a song where I'm making fun of other rappers in the sense that a lot of rappers are real quick to say, they'll say it real fast, Too Short can't rap. Whatever, he, the only reason he sold a million albums is because he always say bitch and, you know, that's all he can do is curse, and anybody can do that. Two Live Crew can do it, anybody, Ghetto Boys can, anybody. You know, they don't really want to give us props because of our explicit lyrics, so I made it in the trunk just to say that whatever the reason is, whatever you may think it is, all these fancy raps you making, as good as you rap, you in the studio making your raps and everybody in the street is playing my stuff, which is, you know, everybody got this loud stereo in the trunk, and that's where I'm at, in the trunk.
Some rappers try to come off positive. Where I'm from, that just ain't how it is. They say rap music is here to stay, but the sucking MCs don't think that way. It took 8 long years before I got my break, so I wonder why rappers make fake ass tapes. You won't get paid like I did, so give up, punk. And while you're in the studio, I'm in the trunk. You got no choice, so
Step Daddy is my song. That's real. It's about all the brothers that go around having babies by these girls, even though they're cute, they don't want to do it to them no more. Somebody gotta fuck them. Somebody's stepdaddy come through. The little kids, they don't know no better. They be like, hey, you know, bring them a toy. Bring them a toy, a sweatsuit. Foot Locker sell little tiny sweatsuits, just little. Buy a little sweatsuit while I'm buying a pair of tennis shoes, bring it over, give it to the little kid, romance the mama. Stepdaddy's in the house, it's cool.
It's my way of telling the brothers, it's in a Too Short way, that, you know, you have these babies by these women and then you leave them alone. Think about what you're doing. It's not just because the girl got a baby, you know, that shouldn't have been the whole mission. Somebody else, once you had a baby and you leave her alone, somebody else got to come keep her company. And usually when the brothers hear about that, they get a little offended knowing that there's other brothers around their baby and all that, but, you know, it's to make some of these brothers think about it.
Stepdaddy, I know what you want. Like the first of the month, ain't nothing but a holiday. When I fuck my way, I'm her worst nightmare, her wettest dream. We always do that freaky thing. And when I'm coming to her house, I know just what she's all about. Don't waste no time, get in it. Keep on humping till my head starts spinning. Whoop that ass like a world champ.
Pretty much, the next single should either be either Step Daddy or Hoochie. I'm almost positive it'll be.
You know, we're all good friends, and you know, as we kept bumping into each other, it was like, hey, you know, you guys got it going on. It was like, yeah, you got it going on. I said, let's do something together. I don't really know whose idea it was, but I was all for it, and it's like, I really wanted them to do the song, because if I would have did it, it would have just sounded like a rap song. They would have been singing on a Too Short song. I wanted to really, like, get a feel of what they were doing. And, you know, we're all from Oakland, so it makes for an interesting comedy. What if the hippest cool group, you know, from Oakland get together with the cool rappers from Oakland? That's what we did.
I'm Short Dog, I wanna take you backstage. And you can read it like it's on the front page. Cause I know something, don't know. Ain't nothing like these groupie hoes. And since Tony made the track, get lost, fool. And tell your girl I'm back singing. Bougie, tryna be bougie. But you're not doobie. Riding on my Snoopy.
Wanna Be Free was inspired by all the times when, you know, in 1989, 1990 was the first time I bought my Mercedes. And I Wanna Be Free was the song that, as I had my Mercedes, was the song that, as I had my Mercedes, all the times I got pulled over and all the times I held my hands out and got arrested and, you know, whatever it was for. I might not have got arrested, I might not have got a ticket, but a lot of times as riding in a Mercedes as a young black man, I was harassed on a small scale. Police never physically hit on me, but I have been abused.
Well, you know, it's about that time for rappers to start really, you know, even it's not brand new. Rappers have been speaking on it, you know, fuck the police, you know, speaking on the police department. You know, songs like fuck the police and, you know the ones we did. And, you know, I think it's about that time after this Rodney King thing happened that a lot of rappers are going to start speaking on it. And I'm pretty sure it inspired a lot of lyrics from a lot of brothers because it did the same to me. And, you know, I made the rap before I heard about the police getting found not guilty and all that. But you can still, I figure every song I do, I will do for Oakland. So I want to be free and you know, just the way I speak on this police harassment type thing is I'm not really speaking on a brutality, you know what I'm saying? Just police harassment. It's an Oakland style. It's told the way we do it, but you probably get a lot of stories out of L.A. You know, Ice-T, N.W.A., they've been talking about it. Ice Cube, they've been talking about it for a long time. It's there. Public Enemy, they told you.
I Want to Be Free was just, I know so many brothers feel like me. You know, you're just walking down the street and they're like, show me your ID. Where you from? Get down on the ground. Get in the car. And you, all kind of stuff. And I Want to Be Free was the song that just, if you feel bad about those kind of things, I would hope this kind of song would make you just say, shit, you know, fuck it.
You know, stereotypes are very real in this world. And it's just very easy to stereotype a person. If you see me with a t-shirt and a gold chain and sweatpants, you know, and I'm driving a Benz, are you gonna think I'm a rapper? Is that the first thing you're gonna think? I don't think so. So it's like, I don't really blame them, and I'm not saying that all police officers are bad. I'm just saying that I just so happen to have experienced a lot of harassment for no reason. You know, you get pulled over, you get imaginary tickets, you get harassed, you get to take you out and they search your car. Sometimes they don't even find anything, so you get to go. Sometimes they find out you got a warrant, or you know, they just give you a ticket or whatever.
Ant Banks was at the Red Robin, kicking it with his partners, right? Kicking it with your partners, they got a little too loud. And you know, you get a little loud, they come over and they say, hold the noise down. You might hold it down, you might not. You drinking, it's a bar. It's a restaurant bar. You drinking, you eating, you getting intoxicated. They say, hold the noise down. You hold it down for maybe 30 seconds, 2 minutes at the most, and it gets back loud. So when you leave, they find out, oh shit, this young black guy's riding in a Mercedes. What are you doing? What are you doing in this Mercedes, young guy? And you get pulled over and they find out that you have a traffic warrant. And it's like, you never, in the first place, the only reason you got pulled over is because you was a young black man in a Benz. That's why you got pulled over. If you were riding in your Maxima, you wouldn't have got pulled over, Ant Banks. If you was in your Maxima, you wouldn't have got pulled over. Never. I had a Maxima, I never got stopped. I never got a ticket in my Maxima. But I got plenty of tickets in the Benz. Plenty. You get used to it. That's why I end the song. I say, I'm not mad, I'm just black. It's cool. I'm used to it. I know how to deal with it.
What do I think about the police? It was always, for some reason or another, it was always, they were against us. Yeah. Always. Me, myself, a lot of times, I've been checked for no reason.
It only takes a second to pop the trunk. And just like that, you know it's real. You're in the right damn time to get killed. It's all about the game and nothing else. You come out here, you better watch yourself. Cause you can wear what you want, even blue or red. But cross the wrong brothers and end up dead. You catch your body full of bullets and get grafted. Trying to be a gangster, but you just ain't lasting. This little town is getting wild as hell. Check the penitentiaries and all the jails. If they can lock us all up, that would be just fine. Got my partners from Oakland doing serious time. You can't argue with the truth, it's hard to be black. But it's a mind game and you gotta deal with that. I wake up every day and I just can't wait to make more money. Cause back in the days when I rap, I did the same damn thing I do now. Grab the microphone and show you how. But I was broke, the only thing I had was game. I started making money and new things would change. Bought a Benz, thought it might earn respect. But the OPD found it hard to accept. I got jacked by the task and jacked by the vice. Face down on the ground, keep my hands in sight. Put the handcuffs on, backseat, I'm in it. Illegal search for about 30 minutes. Asking me, where's the dope? Where's my gun? But I don't know. I said I'm rapping, they laugh like I told a joke. And to this day they think I'm selling coke. I'm being up in California every day of my life. Bass so hard, you think I'm smoking a pipe. And if I don't smoke it, I got to grind.
Searched all my stuff, and all you find is a pocket full of money, count 7 G's. Now you wanna think I'm selling keys, cause I'm a black man, but I run my own prison. So why the police wanna send me to prison? They see a brother making major cash, then I can patch out his black ass. And that's the truth, you can't argue at all. Trying to give 10 years for a phone call. Ain't even tripping on a dang smoke, cause all they wanna find is guns and coke. In court all the time trying to fight it. We get rich, we get invited. So what's the problem, officer, this time? It's having big money, being